Hello, everybody. Welcome again to Price Links. My name is Phil Flynn. I'm Senior Market Analyst at the Price Futures Group, as well as a Fox Business Network contributor. One of our favorite guests who gets all the accolades, the excitement. It's Long-Term Frank, ladies and gentlemen. Long-Term Frank Patryka, back again from the Price Group to talk about the next big move. Frank, thanks for being here, my man.
Good to see you, man.
Long-term. You're telling me you're seeing
some kind of... Wait a minute. Okay. What about the Cubbies?
The Cubbies. Cubs.
Cubs.
Oh, this crude oil under barrels? No. Cubs. Oh, the baseball team.
Come on, Phil.
Yeah, okay, got it. I grew up on the South Side. We didn't get too much Cubs. Yeah, down in Beverly. Yeah, when it came to baseball, we had two favorite clubs, the Go-Go White Sox and was ever playing the Cubs. But anyway, got to congratulate him. The first time in 80 years.
Exactly.
No cows, no black cats.
No.
They did it. They're there. And they're playing Cleveland. This sounds like a punchline to a bad joke, but it's true. Cubs in Cleveland.
I am telling you, the city is buzzing. Man.
They are buzzing.
But I'll tell you,
I've been through Cubs playoffs before because I've seen
your
heart's
broken.
But there was a lot of nervousness in these playoffs. There were.
I'm telling you right now, I've got a good vibe.
He's got a good vibe.
I have a good vibe. Well, I think they're going to win it.
Well, they're the best team in baseball. We'll see if you're right. And we'll see if you're right on your long-term call on the commodities, which today you were talking about a new bull market in a particular commodity. What might that be?
Energies.
Energies, Phil, a new bull market in energies.
You know, our last video, we talked about crude oil.
We did.
Okay, crude oil was trading at 45.
Right, roughly
market
in that area.
Has already rallied to 51 or 52.
It has. Okay. Pulled back a little bit recently. But it was an incredible run.
Well, I called you.
Yeah.
And I said, Phil, it happened.
It did happen.
It happened. We're in the midst of accumulating heating oil. And gasoline futures, or the RBOB.
RBOB, Alubop. Yes, RBOB futures.
And all I can say, it's very, very exciting. No guarantees.
Well, you know what I think is amazing about this market? We're in the heart of the shoulder season when it comes to the fundamentals. Refinery runs at a record low. Mm-hmm. We've got the dollar just off an 8-month high. Mm-hmm. And guess what? When we look at inventories, we're going through inventories. We should be building inventories, but they've fallen on average. Almost 5 million barrels a week for the last, 6 weeks. So that's a sign to me that this market's getting in balance.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And everybody's talking about this glut. Gluts go very quickly. And I'm looking at the difference between supply and demand. And if we might not have a glut in a few months, we might have a deficit.
Right. Well, another thing that I'm looking at, I heard you talking in the control room about the dollar.
Yes.
The dollar index.
Yeah.
Now, the dollar index has been rallying.
It has.
And, our last video, I said a lot of my bullishness, insofar as the energies are concerned, is the weak dollar. Now, in my opinion, first of all, my long-term formula is down for the dollar. So I'm bearish dollar to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
I'd love to sell the dollar at 102, 103. But, again, my long-term vision is for the dollar to be major bear market. The only reason the dollar is going up right now is because of the Brexit situation.
Right. That's true.
All the other currencies have been supported.
Right.
The Japanese yen, the Australian, the Canadian.
Right. And the Fed comments haven't been helpful for the dollar. They're talking about raising rates and maybe three times next year, maybe this
exactly.
week. Maybe that's, of course, this is what they said a year ago and it never happened.
In my opinion, this is a phony bull market. The U.S. dollar index is a phony bull market, and you will see the market drop precipitously next year.
Right.
One of the reasons I feel this way, Phil, is money printing.
Right.
We keep pumping money.
Mm-hmm.
And, basically, it's propping the phony stock market.
Well, but let me ask you this. We looked at the dollar's been rallying.
It's paying for low interest rates.
But oil's still hanging at 50. You would have thought with that kind of move in the dollar, we would have dropped $10. But we're hanging a lot closer to the highs for the year than we are near the lows for the year.
Exactly.
That, to me, is a strong sign. And what's going to happen if you're right on the dollar call?
Right.
Where could that put oil? So how quickly do you think the dollar could break?
Let me tell you something. We are in the beginning stages, and I'm going to put this in my newsletter. It's coming out on Friday. I'm going to detail this in my newsletter. We are in the beginning stages, as far as the dollar is concerned, as far as the economy is concerned, with Germany.
Right.
In 1923.
Whoa.
I'm telling you, it's not happening. Not right now, obviously. But if you take a look at my letter, I have a, you know, a pretty good reasoning behind that.
Frank, how can people get this letter? Because I know they're going to want to find out what the reasoning is.
Call me. Okay. 312-286-9320.
Right.
My letter, go to my website, longtermfrank.com.
Right. And the Cubs in how many?
I'm saying Cubs in five.
Cubs in five. Whoa, there you go. Cubs in five.
Yeah.
And watch out for the dollar and get a special report on that Germany. Frank, thanks for being here.
Thank you, Phil.
And go oil under a buck. No, that's not what it means. Okay. Thanks, everybody, for PriceLinks.
Thanks.